Welcome to Dan's On Fandoms, I'm Dan. Following the death of Emperor Palpatine on the second Death Star, Sentinel Messenger droids were dispatched to deliver the late Emperor's final command to initiate Operation Cinder, an orbital bombardment campaign devised by the Emperor to punish the Galactic Empire for failing to prevent his death. Much time, energy, and resources went into ensuring Operation Cinder would be effectively initiated should the Emperor die, and Star Wars The Bad Batch may have subtly shown how the Emperor was able to lay the framework that would eventually culminate in the initiation of Operation Cinder some two decades later. So, how did Palpatine ensure Operation Cinder's successful initiation, and how exactly does Operation Cinder connect to the events of The Bad Batch? In Alexander Freed's fantastic canon novel Victory's Price, it was revealed that the Emperor's Sentinel Messenger droids only delivered Palpatine's final instructions for Operation Cinder to a select number of Imperial officers. After one of the Emperor's Sentinels had its programming analyzed, it was discovered that those officers that were selected to receive the dead Emperor's final command were determined to be most likely to go along with his genocidal plan for Operation Cinder. To determine which Imperials were best suited to orchestrate Operation Cinder, the Sentinels sorted through profiles that had been created for everyone that served the Empire. These profiles were formed from information that was stored in a massive military database created by the Empire. The database was kept on Coruscant and was housed beneath the Imperial Palace and stretched all the way to Coruscant's Verity District miles away, which is where the bulk of the database was housed. The database contained an enormous amount of data on those within the Empire, consisting of information such as psychological evaluations, combat records, family histories, hobbies, cultural background, and even information on whether individuals stood straight enough for the Imperial Anthem when it played. Furthermore, the data bank recorded every awful, illegal, and vile action committed by an Imperial. Every time a massacre was committed, every time a civilian was killed or treated poorly, and every time a vile act, whether authorized or not, was committed, that information was catalogued and stored in the Emperor's database. In doing so, the Emperor was able to track and monitor how well his underlings exuded the ethos of his Sith-led empire, which aided in his ability to create a political system that encouraged self-interest and corruption. This allowed the Emperor to carefully assess the moral state of those within the Empire by cataloging all of their decisions and actions, allowing him to ensure his empire operated as intended. And once the Emperor died, his Sentinel droids were able to access this massive database, sort through every single profile of those that served the Empire, and then selected the Imperial commanders who were most likely to follow through with the Emperor's final orders to unleash Operation Cinder on the galaxy. Most likely, some kind of unique identifier would have been needed to be able to capture and catalog data on Imperial personnel, and the Empire did provide their Imperial personnel with what they called operating numbers, which were an alphanumeric code used to identify personnel of the Galactic Empire. Presumably, these operating numbers were used to capture and catalog all the data the Empire wanted on an individual, which brings us now to the Bad Batch. So how exactly does this all tie back to the events of what we've seen thus far in the Bad Batch? While this has not yet been confirmed, I believe that chain codes and their creation opened the door for Palpatine to lay the framework that would eventually lead to the construction of his massive military database on Coruscant. Chain codes were a type of identification marker that contained biographical information on an individual. They were attuned to a subject-specific biometrics and cataloged certain features of a person and their history. Chain codes were made up of several numbers, with the final four digits signifying the subject's age, and they contained other information as well, pertaining to topics such as a person's family history and criminal record. This information could then be used by the Empire to identify any of its galactic citizens. Think of chain codes as a Star Wars version of a social security number, but with far more identifiable information. In the Bad Batch episode Cut and Run, which takes place in 19 BBY, we saw the Empire beginning to implement their new chain code system, making it nearly required for galactic citizens to sign up to receive a chain code. The creation of chain codes allowed the Empire to begin to catalog its citizenry, which would have provided them with the know-how and framework to create an internal database for those within Imperial service. Thus, chain codes acted as a tool for the Empire to catalog and control their citizens, much like how the Emperor's military database provided provided him with the ability to catalog his Imperial personnel and ensure their actions were rooted in malice, self-interest, and corruption. Although operating numbers did not provide the same information contained within a chain code, they most likely were used to capture even more information than what a chain code provided. The Emperor was a master planner, so it stands to reason that he'd want to create databases for both the citizens of the Empire and one for Imperial personnel, providing the Sith Lord with resources to access information on pretty much anyone that resided within the Empire. While it's yet to be officially stated in canon that chain codes aided the Emperor and the Empire in creating their massive database on Coruscant, it's easy to see how chain codes would assist them in creating a system whereby the Empire was able to catalog, monitor, assess, and profile every single individual within its ranks. Chain codes appear to be a precursor to what the Empire planned to do with its own personnel, culminating in a massive database on Coruscant that would be used to create profiles for Imperial personnel, eventually resulting in the Empire's Sentinel Messenger droids providing select Imperial officers with his final commands to implement Operation Cinder upon the Emperor's death in 4BBY. But what do you guys think? Do you think chain codes were a precursor to Palpatine's massive military database? Let us know down in the comments. If you like this video, please help out the channel by hitting that like button and making sure you subscribe. Follow the channel on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, all at Dan's on Fandoms. Thanks for watching, and stay